I'm Mashi Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Haumph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
All right. Hello, everyone. Tom Martell, Channel Fireball, bringing you a standard daily here. Freshly back from the Pro Tour. Hopefully I don't fall asleep while recording this. I'm playing my Abzan list that I played at the PT. It's a pretty standard Abzan Control list. The real spice and difference here is it plays three copies of the card Den Protector, which I like a lot. This hand is not great, having two Elspeths already, but I'm going to go ahead and keep it. We have Thoughtseize and we have three Temples, so we can really dig for some more business. And Elspeth is the best card in a lot of matchups. And having two means, you know, you can just kind of run it out there, let them kill the first one. Gonna put Abzan Charm on top so we can draw some cards. Don't really want to see a Mountain here. Would love to see Abzan Aggro, frankly, with double this in the hand and that Abzan Charm. Also fine with Islands. It's hard to lose the Islands with Abzan. Alright, so we have a hand of Blight, Dissolve, Scorn, Boogan, Dig, Strand, Delta. We're going to Scry again and play an Abzan Charm. So Elspeth not at its best in this matchup, unfortunately. Here they're just going to take Dissolve. I'm not too worried about Dig Through Time. Scorn's also kind of annoying because you can just Scorn our Charms. We can't play until turn 4. With an untapped name. I'm going to take Dissolve, though, here. Rhino's not a card we really care about in this matchup. Just want to get ahead on cards. Yeah, this is actually... Our opening hand was quite poor for this matchup, because both Elspeth and Alter Price are bad here. I guess Elspeth's okay, but... Alter Price is, like, actively a dead card. Don't want to drop extra lands, because you're going to draw plenty. We're playing 26 mana sources. So you don't need to prioritize scrying lands at the top here. And we go ahead and Abzan Charm his upkeep. So we can't score it unless he drew a dragon. Good, we drew Read the Bones. Read the Bones is our best card for this matchup. Looks like he doesn't have a third land yet, also, which is nice. So we know about Blight, Scorn, Ugin, and Dig. He has three more cards in his hand that we don't know about. So it looks like he either drew a dragon for a Scorn or he drew a Dissolve. Yeah, he's dissolving this. Which is actually fine. He missed the land drop. We're forcing him to double fetch. So he gets a Scry out of it, but he does thin two lands out of his library. So that's not what exactly he wants to be doing here. And he Scries to the top. That's too bad. Oops, should have played the Plains there. That doesn't really matter. So... Found a Haven. Now he's enough mana to cast Dig. Alright. We drew a Den Protector to go get something here. Could just get the Thoughtseize and cast it. Force him to Scorn that. Rather just wait though. I think I actually just want to get Read the Bones. Don't really mind if he digs here. He's short on mana, so if he digs, he has to take a land. So it's not even that great for him. The one thing he can potentially do is he can go get a dragon. Off the dig to turn on the Scorn. But say he just gets a dragon and he taps out for Ojutai, we just get to play Elspeth and minus it, which is huge. So he can't even Ojutai us here. It's possible he's just blue-black and playing... Oh, no, he can't. He's playing Scorn. I was going to say he's just playing Haven for the Ugins, but he's probably playing something similar to the Esper list that most of Channel Fireball played. Depending on what he does in his turn, we can decide between Read the Bones and Thoughtseize. We're hoping for land Ojutai here, but yeah, we're not going to see that happen. So I'm just going to get back, Read the Bones. Keep running him out of counter spells here. That's a good draw. It's a great draw. Now we can force through a Read the Bones. Don't actually care if this resolves or not. I mean, it'd be nice if it resolves so we can see what he's working with over there. Alright, so he has Ugin, Scorn, Blight, Downfall, Ingenuity. And he does not have two black mana untapped. He does have two blue. We should take Ingenuity here and cast Read the Bones. And bottom both of these. Still not much action, so he drew Backwater, okay. So he only casts one Scorn here. And we drew Thoughtseize. We don't really care about Thoughtseize any of his cards at this point. We could Thoughtseize the Downfall, but I don't really care if he downfalls my Elspeth. Especially since he tapped out here, he can't do it until his next turn. Which is kind of great. So he has another Bioblade, he can clean up these tokens after he downfalls my Elspeth. But then I'll just play the second Elspeth. Jeez, we are Thoughtseize rich. Thoughtseize millionaires. Well, we will Thoughtseize him. He's on 6 mana, so he still can't cast Ugin. He uses Downfall. He drew another Downfall. Okay, so he has Blight, Downfall, Scorn's Run. So we just take this Downfall and play the next Elspeth. He'll get to Blight the tokens, but that's fine. We can't Thoughtseize him because he can just Scorn it, and just the Force Spike would counter it. I would take the Battle Blight if I could do it for free. I would definitely Thoughtseize Battle Blight in that spot. But actually, what happened, I want him to draw Silumgar. If we draw Silumgar, he'll tap out for it. We'll just get to the Crux it, hit him for 6, make 3 more, and then Battle Blight and take the Thoughtseize and take Battle Blight. So it'll actually work out really poorly for him if he draws a dragon right there. Ooh, interesting. Oh, shoot. I should have thought these first. That was actually just atrocious. Yeah, that was really bad. Now I don't have the... Ugh. He would have had a bile blight response. Wow, that was so bad. Yeah, if I thought it forces him to Battle Blade, they get three tokens at the end, which is the whole point of using the Battle Blade there. I think I just hold this Thoughtseize now. Yeah, there's no reason to Thoughtseize now that I've missed that opportunity. I want to keep pressure on his life total, so I might as well keep the... Oh, I'm going to just... What am I talking about? I'm just going to ultimate price the one he Battle Blades. So I actually should have Thoughtseized. This whole sequence was pretty awkward. Now if he drew a dragon, he can actually counter my thing. Okay, but he did not. Or at least I found the ultimate price line before I lost all my tokens for no reason. Sure, he can crux me. Plays Temple, so he's going to play Ugin next turn, but we'll Thoughtseize it here. He scries the top, so he probably scried a land to the top, thinking that it's going to be useful. But we'll leave him just two Scorns in his hand. And now we're threatening to ultimate Elspeth and kill him. And I'm pretty sure he left a land on top. I'm going to ultimate Elspeth. It's possible he left something else on top. Like Bile Blight. Okay, good. Alright, got the first one. Now, going to sideboard in some interactive stuff. Two more Read the Bones, we can keep up with him on card advantage, and two Duresses. And then we actually swap in Crux of Fate for Inhostilities. I like Crux of Fate in this matchup. He's going to tap out at points in time to try to... I have two down balls. To play dragons, right? Ojutai and Silumgar, and we'll just get to wrath them away and leave our creatures in play, which is pretty great. I don't hate downfall in the matchup, depending on how many planeswalkers they go up to. Sometimes they even want a third one in. But I think Crux is generally better against them. Ken cut an Elspeth. Elspeth's kind of slow, but as you saw that game, it does eventually win the game. And they only have downfall to kill it. Sometimes maybe they have like a vault. But I think it's pretty good, usually in these matchups. If we know for a fact that he has like three Aishiox, then I like leaving in one more downfall and cutting an Elspeth. I'll have to mulligan this one. But we will keep this. Bad hand, but better than I think they're going to five. Ooh, that's a great draw. We have so much card drawing in that we can recover from Logan's pretty effectively here. So the best thing we can draw right now is a duress effect. Mardu Strike Leader? What the frick is going on? Huh. Transformational aggressive sideboard. Well, I'm going to cast Read the Bones. Now, I'm not sure how good this transformational sideboard he has going on here is, because we still have a bunch of removal in our deck that kills this thing. He's going to get to his once, and it's going to leave a token behind, which is certainly somewhat annoying. We're doing a lot of damage to ourselves here. So many dragons. So I'm just gonna play. Now I wish I had Inhostilities and not this Crux of Fate, actually. I think I'm gonna take Dig Through Time and then just Abzan Charm his Strike Leader. Yeah, I like that. So he'll play a dragon, probably here. I expect him to play Ojutai. Could have just taken Ojutai there. I think he just cast Dig in this spot. I didn't want to just dig right here. I played Regent. Okay. Interesting, he didn't go get White Mana with his Flooded Strand. What the heck? I'm just gonna play Rhino here and Scry, I think. He has Downfall, he'll Downfall my Rhino. That's fine though, he uses mana. And then I can just play Elspeth and plus it. So confused why he didn't go get a white mana source. Maybe he drew the planes? Oh, he might not be playing planes. Some of these lists don't actually have planes in their deck. So I could Elspeth minus here. Can also just play Den Protector. I like that, actually. Just play Den Protector, trade for his token. I'm trying to set up a board state where I can just cast Elspeth, minus it, and not have it immediately die. And this warrior token's making that a little challenging. He draws removal spell here, it's not great for me. Not get killed here. I'm probably gonna die. All right, please. Oh no, I'm just dead to the flyer. Right, I'm just dead. Okay, that was interesting sideboard plan for him. Do I want to change anything? So I'm bringing one in Hostilities instead of a Crux of Fate. I should have just Cruxed the stupid. Once I didn't have white mana, it was just really bad. I should have just Cruxed the dragon away. There's just no reason to take the line I took. Yeah, if I just Cruxed it right away. They stabilize really easily. Because he couldn't cast Ojutai. I don't know, him playing Regent versus really threw me. So I don't know if he doesn't have a Plains to fetch. Gotta keep this. Hand's not great. That's a good one to draw. Strike leader's actually good. Interesting. Ultimate price? What the heck? I'm just taking ingenuity here, I think. Like, even with downfall, Ugin, price, caves, two swamp. So he has one whites. He only has one, he bottomed. He only has one blue mana. I don't really care if he downfalls my first siege rhino. I just don't want to fall behind on cards. This thing doesn't really do anything. Price is an odd card from having his library. Against my deck. I have so few targets. It happened to immediately draw the Tasker, unfortunately, but... So this first rhino gets downfalled. Which is fine. Maybe I should just take him downfall and try to kill him. I never play this matchup very aggressively, but maybe this is a game where I could have easily gotten aggressive. Does make some sense. So his hand is Swamp, Ugin, Price, and two unknowns. Alright, well, let's draw some cards. Kind of want to just top these. Yeah, I'm just going to top. Taking Ojita. Yeah, we're a little bit soft to Ojita here. Oh man, he has a dig. Could just take the dig and let him just cast Ojita. Think that's actually what I'm going to do. Because dig will, like, he can dig right now. If I take Ojita, he just fetches, gets blue. So I actually have to take dig here. Now he plays Ojita. His hand is just going to be Ugin, Price, and what do we do this turn? Ugin, Price. So I should just play the Den Predictor face down. Hopefully he doesn't draw a counterspell. Hopefully he didn't draw a counterspell. It seems like he's hesitating whether or not he should attack, so that makes me think he did not draw one. If he had a counterspell, he would just be slamming his Ojitai. So given how long it's taking, I'm almost positive he did not draw one. And therefore I really wanted to attack. Okay, and he does not. We'll get our Read the Bones back. Need to find more action here. So what do we know at this point? He doesn't have a counterspell. Oh wait, what? He does have a counterspell? Then why the heck didn't he attack? This dude's crazy. why did we not get attacked by the Zojitai? That just makes no sense. Okay, well, hopefully he doesn't draw another counter spell. Oh, one more mana before I play Tasker. My goal is to play Tasker with 7 mana up, so I can both leave up Downfall and activate. Okay. Man, drawing a Wrath would be sweet. I'm gonna play Rhino here. Yeah, if we do Dragonwrath right there, we won the game. That's annoying. He's playing a bizarre list. Kind of interesting. You normally don't see Jason Jr. with all the dragons. There's just so many fives that he's playing. This is very unusual. Alright, well, we're going to give him the business. Yeah, it was a bunch of cards in hand. If he drew Dragonwrath, if he drew Crux here, we actually might be in trouble. Yeah, okay. Wow, I really want to draw Dragonwrath. My kingdom for Dragonwrath. Come on, deck. Let me Dragonwrath him. Interesting. Okay, so he's at 6. I think I just jam both. Seems like I can eat very simple jam both. Question is, do I put 2 counters on the Ojitai is blocking, trample over for 2, put him to 4. If I do that, then I can't. I'm 1 mana short of doing everything I want to do. I also want to just downfall his dude. I'm at 12. I guess I just put 2 counters on. Oh wait, he's only 1 mana short of Ugin-ing me. We know he has Ugin and Price in his hand. I think I'm just gonna trade and kill Icefell Regent. Oh, this is tough. What if I just... Oh man, we really need 1 more mana. Given the whole Ugin situation. I think I'm just going to trade. Debating like various Den Protector morph lines. There's like, I'm trying to see if there's like a Tasker line that's reasonable, but there really isn't. I'm just gonna trade, I think, and then face down my. Whereas I can't face down the Den Protector because then he just attacks with both and just kills it with the Silumgar triggers. I think I have to just deal with this Regent, and to do that, to exile it. Because I need to save the downfall for the Ugin. My top card's Crux will be sad. Okay, we have the untapped land, at least for the Ugin. Now we really want to draw a land. That, unfortunately, is a tap land. So 1 minute short of doing all the things I want to do. We know there's an ultimate price in hand. I don't want to just feed this Tasker to his ultimate price. I think I might set the play this Den Protector and hope he doesn't have a downfall. I don't want to just not do anything here. And the Protector is really awkward because I don't have enough mana to play it, unmorph it, and play Rhino. I might need to cast this Rhino to not die to Silumgar. That's unfortunate. Alright, so we'll play Tasker. We'll get to activate it once, twice if we draw an untapped land. Oh no, we had Haven. Alright, so we're just dead. Yeah, we just died. Man, that's lame. He didn't really draw any card draw. Yeah, there's nothing we can do when he gets that Ugin and just kills us. Darn. Matchup's very good for us, but I mean, if we drew Crux of Fate or Wrath, we won this game easily. But yeah, I just think this Silumgar just killed us. I've actually never lost to blue black with this list, but so many dragons. We just didn't draw any way to interact with them. Oh well.